Remember this one? International Harvester Red Singer 66 from 1915. Well, take a look at this. I put an AlphaSo NA35 motor on it. The NA35 is the 0.9 ampere 7,000 RPM motor. And let's get a couple stitches there. All right. Watch this. Take a look at that stitch. That, my friends, is what a Singer 66 is meant to do. God, I love these machines. Well, we've seen all these component parts before. So let's go ahead, let's put it back together again. First things first, we're going to take the pivot screw that normally goes here. And we're going to establish that onto the belt guard. Get the bracket established in position. Notice I've got it all the way out so that the screw can go all the way down, which will allow that to be in its proper place, the bracket in its proper place. And we'll put this right around the middle of its travel. About there. Okay? And we'll crank that down. And then we'll go ahead and we'll back this screw back out because we're going to need it. Now, on the back of the winder itself, and by the way, when I painted this, I got paint all over where I didn't need to get it, and it really was a pain in the neck. All right, we have the little tail coming off, and we have this little tail coming off. This little tail is going to go in that hole. Let me get my pointer. It's going to go in the hole all the way down here. Oh, get my hand out of the way. All right, that's where it's going to wind up going. So we're going to put that in, that tail in there, and then kind of bring that around. Get our pivot bolt back through. Yeah, we'll get that in position once we get this happening here. And we will get our bolt started. This is a lot easier if I don't have to worry about trying to make it so you can see what I'm doing. There we go. Now it's started. And we'll run that in. Notice, okay, three holes. The spring has two pins coming off. I'm going to put a pin in the center hole for alignment purposes. There's one hole right here. Let me see if I can get that so you can see that a little easier. Right there. That's going to receive the pin that's coming off the spring. We're going to get this screw started. Actually, I'm not liking that. We're going to go ahead and we're going to move that to the left hole to try to get that in a little better orientation. All right, and get that back, the pin back in that other hole. And we're just going to start the screw. We're not going to run it in very far. Just a little bit so it's started. And then we're going to very carefully work that back. So it's kind of hooked on like that. And we will run that screw in. And now we have a good snap action. This is nothing we haven't done before. We've done this a lot before. Okay, next step. Now, I did put the cam back on the gear. All right. So sue me. I didn't take it off again. We put the eccentric screw in. We have the concave washer with the concavity towards the bracket. Slip the screw and that on and just get the nut started on the back, the square nut. Get it started on the back. Now, ooh, did I hit it out of the park? Almost. Turn that screw to minimize the backlash, but you want a little bit. You don't want a lot. You want a little bit of backlash in there. That's not enough. It's just a little bit of backlash. That's fine. And then we can take our wrench. In this case, I'm using this one's taking a 5/16. Now, hold on. I'm going to cheat. Normally, I suggest getting a second person to help if you can't do this by yourself. But I happen to own a little machinist vise. And I've never done this way. I'm going to put the screwdriver in the machinist vise. Actually, that's too long. Let me use the shorter bit holder in the machinist vise. Okay. Now, double checking my backlash. That's still good, just a tiny amount. Get the screw or the screwdriver in the slot. I'm just holding this, I should be able to tighten this now without worrying about changing my gear lashing. Woohoo! That worked. I hope you could see that. I'll have to review the footage. I might have gotten my paws in the way. But that worked for holding the screwdriver. All right, let's put a bobbin tire on and spin that. And that is, in fact, turning. Okay, so one more part to put on. Okay, once again, there's three holes inside. On the spring, there's a prong that's close aboard and a prong that's coming out. The prong that's close aboard the spring is the one that goes into the casting. We're going to put it all the way to the left, the hole all the way to the left. Find the hole and push it in. There it is. There is one hole in the thread guide. And we're just going to get the screw slightly started, just so the threads catch. And we're going to bring it down and around, get it up against the cam, and then screw this in the rest of the way. And double check. That follower is definitely going to be tight on the cam. So that's all there is to it. Put the screw back in the top, and we'll mount her back on the machine. To adjust the bobbin winder, we click, make sure that it's disengaged, and that appears to be working. All right, dead nuts in the middle on that screw position, that first screw that we put in up here on the top, that's where we make the adjustments. If this wasn't clicking in, we would loosen it, we would move the position of the bracket, but we got it first shot out of the box. And you can see how it runs. So, there you have it. That's our 66-1 from 1915 that has been completely stripped down, repainted International Harvester red, re-decaled, ready to rock and roll. It's just sitting in this plastic carry case for the moment. I don't know if I'm going to paint that motor red yet or not. I probably will buy another motor, take it apart, and paint it so that the motor does match. But and I haven't decided whether I'm going to keep this machine, whether I'm going to sell it, whether I'm going to donate it, what I'm going to do with it yet. But she does stitch nice, as we proved earlier. The stitches don't lie. She's a good machine. But then again, she's a 66. And I've yet to see a 66 that isn't a fine stitching beast. And this one is certainly no exception. But anyway, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next one, whatever that may be. And hint, the very dirty 66-1 that I started another series on, that one's already painted in navy blue.